Now let's finally take a look at a few advanced options. First, you have to turn on the advanced tools or make sure that they are turned on. Open preferences, and in the general menu, make sure that show advanced tools checkbox is checked. Now let's select a clip that we want to create a picture in picture, one of the advanced options, and let's select this one, and let's, for example, say we want to do a picture in picture here. We drag that clip on top of the clip we want to insert it in and release, and we get all of these various options, and I'm going to select picture in picture. And so now you see what's happened. It has iMovie has created a window within this background clip, and we can move this window, resize it. And this is a video clip, so when we hit play,
as the shoreline has retreated, the oaks have died, and now all you see are the skeletons that you see lying here on the beach behind me.
And so you see that it has created this picture in picture, and what I'm talking about can be seen in that picture. Or we could choose to do a cutaway instead of a picture in picture, and I'll show that very quickly. We'll select cutaway, and now when this plays, a final option I'll cover is voiceover. As before, you want to have a good microphone, and so all you do is click the microphone icon, and here you will select the audio input, and you either select your built-in microphone, or if you have an external microphone, you select that. You can select the input volume, and you can see the volume increasing and decreasing as I'm speaking. And then to record, there's a direction box here. Click a clip where you want the voiceover to begin. And so if we want it to begin here, I'll tap here and you'll get a 3-second countdown. And then the recording will begin and it'll record. And all you have to do is hit the space bar and the recording will stop. And you see that the recording has now been placed, the track has been placed with that video clip. And you can review that, and if you like it, then you can accept it. Okay, to preview your project full screen, you select the full screen playback button, which is here. And once you're satisfied with your project, then you are ready to export. How you export depends on where your video will be shown. And if we go under Share and select Export using QuickTime, we're given a number of options. Here we can select to export movie to QuickTime Movie, or if, for example, we want to watch it on Apple TV, then we would select Movie to Apple TV. But for now, I'm going to select Movie to QuickTime Movie. And taking a quick look at the options, we can vary the settings, the compression type, and various other settings. And for now, I'll leave it on the default settings. We also want to select the size, and I would recommend selecting one of the HD versions. And make sure sound is selected, and I'll leave the default positions on those settings for now. And if we select OK, and all we do is select Save after naming our movie project, select Save, and then it will export, and that will take a few minutes. Now that's finished exporting, we can find the file on my desktop. We'll minimize this window, and here's the file right here, and we can open it. If you wish to publish to a video sharing site, then those options are available as well. And we'll look under Share and we'll take a look at YouTube quickly as an example. You will need a an account, and all you do then is put in your password and some information about your video. And once it's uploaded, you can send the video links to others or embed the video on your website. Well, those are a few basic directions to get you started with iMovie. For more information, look at the iMovie help or the many other tutorials online.